H2K Infosys provides world-class online IT training, staffing, and software testing solutions to customers worldwide. H2K Infosys supports 100% job-oriented training, hands-on project work, cloud test lab, resume preparation and review, mock interviews, robust syllabus. One-time pay, lifetime access to live classes and videos. H2K Infosys has won the trust of thousands of students worldwide. For free demo class, visit h2kinfosys.com.
Muted.
Okay. So if you can see my screen, and this is the course content. If you have not received, you will receive it today. Just make sure you send me your email ID. Yes, I'll send you yesterday's video as well as today's video to everyone, actually. And this is a course content. So the whole idea is I share the course content to everyone and in this free class so that you can have a look to it and understand what we are going to cover. I make sure that by the end of this training, not this free 3 days class, but at the end of the actual training, I make sure that I have covered everything, all the topics, and you have understood all the topics, okay? Now let's go straight away to Informatica, where we are struggling yesterday. So to open the Informatica, right now you do not have Informatica installed in your system, but when it's installed, this is how you open your Informatica. You go to all programs, you will find Informatica there. 9.1, you click there, you client, and you pass into clients, and this is the designer. Let it open, okay? So when you open the designer, it looks something like this, and I want to connect to, these are called repositories, okay? I'll come to that later on, but this small green in boxes you see, these are called repositories. So I want to connect this repository. You double click this repository. It will pop up the, user ID and password window. Okay, let me see if the running, okay, it's not running, sorry, let me just start it again. Just a minute. You do not have to do this, it's just because I have installed it and I prefer to keep the service off. So that's why it's like that. Anyway, it's going to take time, a little while. But let's continue the class. So today what we will do is we will try to see some of the basic areas of Informatica, how it looks, what we can do in different windows that we will see. And also, we will do, not today, but today and tomorrow, what we'll do is we'll try to do one mapping end-to-end, and we will run it, we'll see the results. What happened? We'll see the results. That way, you will have an idea that how to run the Informatica mappings, how to do the Informatica development, how to run the mappings, and how to see the results. So we'll do one mapping end-to-end. Very basic one, but we'll see that one. Just bear with me, I'm trying to start my services so that we can start the Informatica. But you, in real time, you do not have to do this. It's just because I have manually switched off the services, that's why. I'm so sorry I'm wasting your time, but this is not supposed to be like this. It was running even today morning. Okay, so this is why, when you connect to a repository, this is how it looks like, okay? In the left-hand side, you see a lot of folders, and that is how it will look like in your Dell project. Usually what we do is that we create the folders based on the developer names, or not the names, basically user IDs. So that's also, you will find there is a dedicated folder for you where you have to do all your development, okay? Now, let's say we want to go to the free session folder, and we want to do all our development there. So when you go there, let me do one. Let me clean everything so that we do not have. We'll do everything from scratch, right? So I'll just clean everything. Just give me a minute. Let me just clean everything so that it should look like a fresh new. Let's delete everything. Okay. So if you when there is no object created in any of the folder, this is how it looks like. There is a fresh new folder created for you. So this is how it will look like. Now this window is where we are right now working. D is called Informatica Power Center Designer. We have two other windows where you would be worse. So now if you are a developer, you will spend most of your time in Informatica Power Center Designer. And I would say 50% of your time in Power Center Designer, then next 30% time on the Workflow Manager, and then 20% time on the Workflow Monitor. But if you are a tester, then it's a little different. You will be spending more time in Workflow Manager and Workflow Monitor rather than in developer. Okay. Now we will go through all these different windows eventually, but let's understand this one. If you look here, there are small workspace. This is called Source Analyzer. This is Target Designer. This is Transformation Developer. This is Mapper Designer. This is Mapping Designer. So in this free session, we will cover three of them. One is Mapping Designer, one is Target Designer, and one is Source Analyzer. We'll see what is the utility of these three. And also we'll go through this Workflow Manager and Workflow Monitor. Let's understand what is the purpose of a designer. So usually this is what I give example to everyone, all my students in different sessions, that just think about it. When you are planning for a vacation, what you do? So you sit down and try to find the dates of your travel, and then you try to find out. So basically you do some research to find out the place where you want to go. Then you try to find out the dates when you want to go. Then you try to see what are the different places you can visit to that particular nearby location. So that way, after doing some exercise for a week or two, you come up with an itinerary plan, right? Saying that, okay, for such and such date, we'll fly out, and such date, we'll come back. And this 7 days or 10 days is my vacation, and these are the different places I'm going to go. And these are different hotels I'm going to stay. You don't know right now. You don't know which or what hotel you will stay because you have not booked the hotels. But you know, okay, I will have to stay in hotels in this locations and these dates. I have to rent a car on this such and such date. I have to return it. So basically, what I'm trying to tell you is you have a complete plan of your vacation, right? But you have not done any booking. So you have not bought your tickets, you have not done any bookings, flight bookings, hotel bookings, rental bookings, any kind of bookings. No, just you have planned it. So that is your designer, okay? Here we plan, we design in how to extract, transform, and load from source to target, but we do not do any kind of actual loading here. Now, let's go back to the vacation example. So once that is done, next step is what you do is you start booking the tickets. So you buy the tickets, you have tickets, you book the hotels, you do the rentals and everything. So that is your workflow manager. What you do is, based on the design what you have done, you start giving the information which is required to manage or run that particular design. So those informations are provided. Now the third step in the vacation is you actually go on vacation on that particular day, right? And then you are on vacation for the next 10 days until you come back. So that is your workflow monitor, where you actually run the mappings and see how the data is being loaded from source to target. Okay? Any questions, anyone, so far? Anyone, any questions? Okay. Now, let's then start with this one. So we will try to do a very simple assignment where we will read the data from a file, we will do some basic, very basic transformations, and we will load the data into another file. Okay, that is what we are going to do. And this is very common because you, when you go to a real project, you will see you will receive data from all different forms. From files, from XML, from database tables, all different things. So we will just start with that file. Now, let me first show you one file. Okay, we will use this file, employees.txt. If you look at this file, this is called a CSV file, or delimited file. Why this is called as delimited file or CSV file? Because so CSV stands for comma separated value. So if you look at the file, the first line of the file is the header, which has all the column names. And all the column names are separated by comma, right? But a second line, from second line onward, it's all data. And again, the data is separated by comma. So how do I map between the column name and the data is basically comma tells me. For example, 100 is employee ID because this is the first value. Stephen is my first name because that is the second value in the file. Got it? So this is called your comma delimited file. Now, what I'm going to do is in the designer, as I have told you earlier, we deal with the design. So first thing what I'm going to do is I will create the structure of my source file. Okay, so you go to the source analyzer. In the source analyzer, you create the structure of your source. So in the source analyzer, you go to the sources and you do import from file, because I already have a file. So what I can do is I can just import the structure from that file, okay? So you do import from file, and then you locate where is your file. So my file is C drive and then SRC files, and then you do file, type of file, you do all files. Okay, and you do employees.txt. That is my file, which I'm. So as soon as you do this, this window comes up and it tells you that whether this is a delimited file or fixed width file. So it's a delimited file, and there's a small checkbox which tells me that import the file names from the first line. Yes, my first line is a column names. So what I'm doing is import the field names from the first line. I'll just check this box. From second line onward, it says start import at row 2. So from row 2, it's basically the data. Do next. And your delimiter is comma by default. And now you can see it has actually separated the data based on the comma. Do next. And it is now taking the field names, which is there in my source file, and finish. When you do this, this is how your source structure looks like. If you look here, what it has done is it has imported the column names from your source file, and then it has, by looking to the data, it has done some kind of prediction of the data type. Some kind of prediction on the data type, but not necessarily that prediction is always right. So, for example, let's just real quick see this. For example, a good classic example here is your phone number. If you look at your phone number is 515.123.456.7, right? So there are two dots, but so it should be string. If you look at my data structure here, the phone number is considered as number. So it's not necessarily that Informatica will be able to identify the data type correctly, but it tried to predict. But if you find that the data type is not correct, or you know the data type is not correct, you can go ahead and change the data type here. So that way you create the structure, apply, okay, and then once you do your changes, few things I want you to notice. In the left hand side, you see there is a folder called sources. As soon as I created this file, not file, as soon as I created the source structure, it has created that one under the folder. So it has created a, not a subfolder, but it has created the structure here and showing up. So once you are done this, you do Control S to save your changes. Unless you do the Control S, it will not save the changes. Okay. Okay, I'll take a pause here. And any questions, anyone, so far about creating the source data structure? Vivek, you have a question, right? So let me unmute you. Hold on, Vivek. If you have a question, either you can raise your hand or you can text me, okay? Vivek, you have a question, I'll unmute you. Hold on. Yeah, Vivek, go ahead. I think you have to unmute yourself.
Okay, can you hear me?
Yeah, we can hear you now.
Okay, my question is, you know how you have the flat file and then you have the employees under that? So, did it actually determine the flat file and the employee, you know, hierarchy? I mean, or would all flat files go under the flat file folder?
Yeah, all flat file goes under this flat file subfolder, you can tell. Because when, if you remember, when I import the file structure, I did source and did import from file. So that tells Informatica that I'm I'm getting the structure from a file. So it has created this subfolder, and if I create, let me create one more here. Okay, Control C, Control V. Actually, you can do here. That's something. You can drag and drop it here, okay? So you want to copy, yes. Let's just rename it as employees one. Next page. So you get one more here. Does that answer your question?
I guess my question is, you know how you see the word flat file, it's one word with a capital F, flat and file. Where did it get that from? I mean, what if somebody else was making the same flat file?
Yeah, so it's basically, you see here, flat file. So let's say if I want to change it, so let's say I want to do here rename, and I want to do here, you see database name. So here I want to do, let's say, my flat file, okay? Okay. So now this has become my flat file.
Okay.
And the one which I copied is still flat file, so it's showing up here.
Okay, so it is something we determine, you know, in our choices.
No, by default it's flat file, but if you want to change it, you can change it.
Okay.
Similarly, if I extract data from, let's say, Oracle, so it will show you the schema name there, from which schema you are extracting the data.
Schema or owner?
Owner. Not the schema.
Okay.
Owner.
Okay.
Yeah. Got it?
Yes. That helps. Thank you.
Thank you. Okay. Anyone else have any other question for me? Now, one thing I want you to notice here is we have just got the structure of the file, okay? We are not dealing with the data itself. Here you don't see the data. It's just the structure, okay? In Designer, whatever we do, we don't deal with the data. We deal with the structure, okay? Metadata, rather. We don't deal with the data itself, okay? Now, let's create another structure. So what my intention is to read the data from this file and do some very basic transformations and load the data to another file. That is a very basic mapping. What I want to do is now, I want to create a target structure. Why I'm creating a target structure? Because I do not have a structure from where I can import. If there is a file which has the structure which I need, I can import. If I do not have, I have to create it from scratch. So, and then if you are actually creating or dealing with the target structure, you have to go to the target designer. Okay, source designer is for source structure, target designer is for target structure. Now in the target structure, what I want to do is targets, and then you do create. Okay, and then you give the name, what name you want to give. So let's say I give employee_TGT. And then you select the database type, so mine is flat file. Create, done. And once that is done, immediately under the target, it show up. Now, for target, it does not show a subfolder kind of structure. It just, everything comes under target. Once done, then I want to add the columns, right? So double click this, go to columns. Now, what I want to do is I want to add columns into my target. So, because I'm creating the target structure, I have to tell Informatica what values needs to be populated into my target. So I want employee_ID, and then I want, let's say, full_name, not the first name, last name. So I will concatenate the first name, last name, and make it a full name. And okay, this small, you see the small square, this is used to add the columns. Okay, so I want another column, which is, let's say, department_ID. Full name, I want to change the precision to 20, and department ID, let's say, give it 10. Okay, so this is the structure I want to create for my target. Any questions, anyone? Apply. Okay, once done, this is how your target structure looks like, and then you save it. Control S. Any questions, anyone? Okay, Bhaskar has a question. How do we define the primary keys target side? Bhaskar, you want me to unmute you? Because when we are dealing with flat files, there is no concept of primary key, right? Primary key comes when it is database table. And right now we are dealing with files only. Does that answer the question? Okay. And Jay Lahari, you have some question. I didn't understand your question. You just wrote M-K-H-I-L-H. Oh, okay. Sorry, maybe there's a typo. Okay, anyone else have a question? No? If you do not have a question for me, then I will just keep this much for today. Okay, this is a very basic thing. We'll just keep this much for today, where we have created the source structure and the target structure. We have imported the source structure. We have not created from scratch, just imported the source structure from an existing file. We have created the target structure from scratch. And next day, tomorrow, when what we're going to do is we'll create a mapping where we will map the source to target. We will add some transformations and to do the basic transformation of full name. And then we will run it. We will load the data. We will see the data. But before ending, I want to tell you this one. All the mappings are done in the mapping designer. So mapping designer is a workspace where you design your mapping, where you do the source to target mapping. Okay? Okay, any questions, anyone? If you do not have a question, then I'll just end the class for today. Mamata has a question. Do we need to add the columns from source to target, and how do we remember it? Yeah, so we will see tomorrow in a mapping how do we connect the source to target. That is called your mapping. Okay. Now, anyone in the class who had not received the yesterday's video and not received yesterday's course content, please feel free to send me your email ID. I will make sure that you receive the video today. Okay. And also tomorrow. Yeah, Vivek, this is not one-hour class. I understand this is not one-hour class, but my class is not bound by hours. My class is bound by content. So even if you talk about the actual training, I make sure that I cover everything here, what is mentioned in this course content. I don't tell people that I will take 20 hours course and that's it. No, my course can go from 22 hours to 26 to 28 hours. It depends upon how long it's taking for the whole class to get this content. So don't go with the hours. Okay, I hope you understand. Vivek, I do not have your email ID. Just ping me your email ID. I'll send you the course content. Okay. Yeah, I'll be emailing you the course content. I got most of the email IDs. So in case if you have not sent me email ID, feel free to send me. I'm stopping the recording. Okay.